नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, आई पूनम डोगरा ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ विचित्र एंटरप्राइजेस वेलकम यू ऑल एंड होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेरी वेल। नाउ फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द स्टेप्स वी फॉलो इन इलेक्ट्रिकल सेफ्टी ऑडिट। सो विल गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप दैट व्हाट ऑल स्टेप्स आर बीइंग फॉलोड एंड हाउ एन इलेक्ट्रिकल सेफ्टी ऑडिट इज बीइंग कंडक्टेड एट साइट। And with that, we'll also see that what guidelines and standards are to be followed in an electrical safety audit. And the major tests which are being conducted at site in an electrical safety audit. So let us see. Now, firstly, talking about what is electrical safety audit. So it's simple, as we are talking about your electrical system and its safety, or we can say safety related to your electrical system. So it's generally a complete evaluation of your electrical system, equipments and practices which are going in your organization related to your electrical system. And we completely ensure that your electrical system comply with the safety regulation, standards and best practices in your industry. And the primary goal of an electrical safety audit is to identify potential hazards there, that where risk is involved, where your electrical system is not perfect, and with that we'll recommend you the corrective actions to mitigate those risks, and it will enhance your electrical safety. Now, coming to the steps involved in the electrical safety audit. So first one, which is the main step, that planning. So in this step, we'll define the scope of work, that what all areas to be checked and what all tests to be done and what all equipments to be audited, what are the objectives of this audit. The second one is gathering information. So after planning or after defining the complete scope of work, information is being gathered. So all the documents related to your electrical system, to your electrical equipments, their manual, their maintenance record, their schematic diagrams, SLD, single line diagram, government NOC related to your electrical equipments, and your electricity bills, all these documents are being collected. And after that, the next step comes, that is on-site inspection. So in this particular step, the auditor with a team will inspect your complete electrical system. So the complete electrical system will be inspected by the team, that how your electrical system is being installed, your circuit breakers are okay, your distribution boxes are working properly, or their circuit breakers are working properly, and how your cables are going, how your cable tray system is going, how your connections are okay or not. So all these things will be checked by the team. And this on-site inspection will be followed by some check according to the regulations. So here comes the second part, where I'll define that what all regulations are being followed in electrical safety audit. So mainly it's CEA, Central Electricity Authority of India, have given safety, electrical safety regulations, or these are the electrical safety rules. And with that, Indian Standards for Electrical Installation, which is IS 732, and Indian Standards for Earthing, which is IS 3043, and Indian Standards for Lighting, which is IS 3646 for lux level, lighting level in the premises, etc., are being followed. And National Building Codes, National Electrical Codes are being followed for electrical safety audit. Now, after walkthrough audit or checking your electrical system with the compliances, next comes testing and measurement. So everything can't be checked by just inspection. So testing is being done in your electrical system. These tests are like thermal imaging, and thermal imaging is being done to check the thermal or temperature of your electrical system. So any increase in the temperature due to loose connection, due to overheating, due to overloading can be checked by thermal imaging. Second comes illuminance test. This test is being done to check your lux level, that is your lighting in the complete premises is good or not. So next one is power analyzer. So analysis of the electricity coming to your premises is being done, and the parameters like harmonics, total harmonic distortion, in voltage, in current, what is your phase voltage, what is your phase current, line voltage, line current, what is the kWh, energy in kilowatt hour, and what is the energy in kVA, what is the power factor. All these factors are being checked. And capacitor of APFC, automatic power factor control panel, capacitors are being checked for their health. Now we have the data of a walkthrough audit and data from the test results. And now we can identify the potential electrical hazards such as overvoltage, overcurrent, inadequate grounding, fault wiring, improper equipment installation. All these things are being checked for risk analysis. Now, after that, the collected documents will be analyzed, like your electricity bills will be analyzed for maximum demand, penalty, rebate, your power factor, and your energy use of the month, of the day. So all these analysis are being done, and after that, a complete report of detailed study, detailed walkthrough, and involving the test results and involving the risk involved and solution will be given, including photograph which we have taken in the walkthrough audit, and complete analysis of the system and solution will be given in the report. So with this, we also give a bonus. If you don't have an updated electrical single line diagram, we will give you an updated single line diagram. For this, we will require your AutoCAD file. So these were the steps involved in electrical safety audit. This is it in this video, and if you want us to do an electrical safety audit, fire safety audit, energy audit in your premises, then you can call us in the given number and you can mail us at info@vpower.in, and you can check our website, that is www.vpower.in. So finally, friends, time to say bye-bye. Thank you for watching.